I mean, it felt good. Felt good just to really put the jersey on, go out there with the guys, kind of break the ice with everything. We didn't get the win, but it felt good to be out there though.
What was that moment like to put the jersey on and walk into an NBA arena for the first time as an NBA player?
Yeah, it was definitely a crazy feeling. You know, for that to be a preseason game and for it to be, you know, have that many people in attendance. I just can't wait for it to be the first real game out there.
When did you know that? When you got that pass from Blake Wesley that you were gonna go tomahawk back and go.
It was really when I looked and the man that was guarding me kind of went across to the other side. So when I looked and seen nobody in front of me, that's kind of when I knew.
Was there what was your takeaway just from, obviously you've been playing with these guys in camp for a while, but being in a real game against other NBA players, what was your biggest takeaway in terms of how you adapted to that situation?
Trying to get adjusted to other defenses quickly, because I mean we've been playing against, you know, each other's defense for pretty much all training camp, open gym. So trying to play against other teams' philosophies and stuff like that, just trying to get adjusted to that as quick as we can. So I mean, just really just understanding each other, kind of building our chemistry as much as we can, and you know we'll get better at that.
How do you feel like you process that in real time, like seeing what they were doing and reacting to it?
I mean, I feel like I processed it pretty good. You know, just kind of being able to be on the ball a little bit more, be off the ball, know when and when not to cut, noticing how they're loading up, how they're in gaps. It's really the little things like that where I can find, you know, spaces to attack.
Is there an adjustment playing against a team full of NBA guys that are bigger, faster, longer than maybe you're used to?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I feel like playing against a team like that, I mean, everybody's good. It's a full roster of guys that can really play. So, you know, you really don't have any time to rest in games like that. So, really just getting adjusted to the physicality and the speed of the game is probably going to be the biggest thing for me.
Getting more comfortable with it as the
game. Yeah, for sure. I mean, I noticed it even as we went along in open gym, as we went along in training camp. You know, I mean, you can only get better day by day. So, I mean, just the more reps I get in the games, you know, I'm only get better with it.
You and Blake, you know, for your defensive effort, did you kind of feel like you guys were feeding off each other? He's so intense defensively.
Yeah, I mean, that was something that me and Blake kind of set the tone with in open gym, kind of trying to be the best on-ball defenders for our team. So coming into a timeout, Coach said he wanted us to kind of up it a little bit defensively. Specifically us two, and I feel like we executed on it.
You think that's something that you guys are going to see quite a bit this year, maybe if things were a little slow or not physical enough, put you guys out there to go after backcourts like that?
I mean, I wouldn't be surprised. You know, just the speed that Blake has, being able to speed guys up in the backcourt, and then me being able to do the same thing and also using my physicality. You know, I feel like that's – It's a great skill that we both have, so just being able to utilize it and, you know, being able to utilize it under a coach like Coach Pop is going to be great.
We got Riley coming over here next. What do you think of his game?
I mean, I feel like Riley's pretty fearless. He's not really scared at any moment. You know, he could really shoot it. I feel like his defense has gotten way better even since when I first saw him in summer league. So, I mean, I feel like he's just only improving. So. Yeah, for sure. I mean, I have supreme confidence in myself, but I feel like that comes from just the work that I put in and, you know, just being able to produce, especially here with my new teammates, kind of just being able to learn them. I feel like just the more reps that we have with each other on the court, the better I'm going to get just understanding them and them understanding me. So. I mean, it's been great. I mean, he's a great guy. You can, you know, pick his brain about anything. I mean, no question is a bad question with him. So, I really just try and utilize that as much as I can. Cause I mean, he's been here the longest. You know, he knows what he's talking about. So just me coming into my rookie year, being able to play under him has been it's been luxury for sure.
Speaking of coaches, have you and Mike Moyse bonded over your shared Connecticut roots?
Yeah, for sure. We talked about Connecticut a couple of times, but yeah, I mean, I love being in the gym with Mike. Super high energy guy. So. He's been a great part of us so far. I know this is his first year as well, so you know, I can't wait to, you know, build a connection, a deeper connection with him, you know, as we move on year after year.
Did you know him before?
No, I didn't know him before. I met him at Summer League, and you know, we clicked ever since. So.
I'm not sure Pop thinks no question is a bad question when it comes to us, though. I know that only pertains to you guys.
Nah, it's all good.
He likes to knock down our questions.
Thank you, Slow.
Appreciate y'all.